Security and privacy. A lot of our work has been motivated by the available infrastructure for databases, for available cloud infrastructure. The Department of ICT has actually offered and has established and offered the Gov Cloud service, which would allow government institutions and agencies to put all of their data and have it be housed in that cloud-like infrastructure. But it doesn't mean that we have stopped working with the National Privacy Commission. As such, as I said, we are also a Chief Data Protection Officer for the university and for PGH. So a lot of our work has been to be able to protect the sensitive personal information that's being requested by the PICs and being processed by the PIPs. For the other question in terms of data privacy or privacy in general and the comparisons between the older generations and the millennials, personally, my philosophical take on that is that privacy has their take on privacy has not really been that different or has not waned all over the years. You would only notice that there was a waning in terms of the awareness or in terms of the value put into privacy just because technology has been a major enabler for you to be able to share all of that information. We didn't have social media in the 70s and 80s. We didn't have all of the VOIPs, voice over internet protocols that are already in place. We didn't have Twitter, we didn't have a platform that was entirely user-driven and the content was put together by the individual users. So we had caracolas, okay? We went to the streets. We had postal mails that were point-to-point, diba? Unless the postman actually opened them. What we had were love letters in yellow lined intermediate pads, diba? What we had were origamis. All of those were point to point, but none of those were actually widely announced to the whole world as such in such a way by way of comparison is such that hello world, I had pandesal with coco jam and tahok this morning, diba? And then you put that on Instagram. Diba? We didn't have all of those things. So all of these cultural and behavioral, let's say, tendencies that were developed over the years, my personal take was that the technology has been a major enabler for that. And I think if that technology were available in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, you could bet that you would probably have seen your parents' Instagram or Facebook posts when they were hippies or when they were in those states. So,
one more question. Okay. About the private, linking the ID with the private hospital.
Oh, yes. So, the work that has been done in terms of the framework that's being used for the open health, that we base on the open health information exchange and which we now call the Philippine Health Information Exchange, a lot of the work has been connecting a lot the government facilities, regional hospitals, provincial hospitals, public hospitals, DH retained hospitals, barangay health centers, the rural health units. The idea is to be able to connect all of those, but that is not to put everything that the government is being that the government is doing in silo. We have been working also with several private groups that have developed their own electronic medical record systems, and not just developed them, implemented them rather successfully. When compared to the six electronic medical record systems or the available HIT providers or HIPPs for the hospitals. So, and other players in the market, let's say international players that have infiltrated, quote-unquote, the Philippine market. Wellsoft is a top electronic medical record system for emergency. It's being implemented in Sintox Medical Center, but the work that's being done in terms of being able to connect and interoperate all of these systems, we are working closely with these institutions so that we will have that very same idea or a concept of having a shared health record available for everyone.